What's up, guys? It's Kelly, and today I've got sort of a swatch review for you, so make sure you hit that subscribe button and the notification bell so you don't miss out on new videos, and let's get started. I am so excited about today's video. I mean, honestly, I'm always excited about my videos because I really love nail polish. I don't know if you guys noticed, but I like nail polish. But I'm especially excited for today's video because I'm partnering up with ORLY Color Labs to share with you guys my experience doing their custom color creation. A bunch of you guys have been asking me to try out the ORLY Color Labs experience, and obviously I haven't been able to fly to LA with what's going on in the world, but the Color Lab is now virtual, so I was able to do it. So let me just take a couple steps back. If you don't know what the ORLY Color Labs is, basically you guys know ORLY. They are a 12-free, meaning they're free of 12 of the dangerous chemicals that are often found in nail polish. They're vegan, they're cruelty-free. They have these massive, beautiful salon bottles with a rubberized cap. They have a custom color lab in LA where you can go and you can actually create your own custom nail polish color. And basically you can just create any color there, whether you're trying to dupe a polish that's been discontinued, or if you just have a brilliant idea for a polish and you can't find that exact color and you just want to make it, or if you just want the experience of making your own nail polish, that is what happens at the Color Lab. So they are now offering these virtual experiences. And once I found that out, I was super excited. So I decided to try it myself. So basically I'm just going to talk you guys through the whole experience, choosing the color that I want to be my custom color on the website, doing the Zoom meeting with the color mixer, and working to create the exact color that I had in my brain. And then I'm gonna swatch it for you guys and show it to you. Obviously, spoiler alert, it's on my nails, but don't look. But yeah, so let's start off at the beginning. I'm gonna show you guys my experience choosing the color. So let's move it on to past Kelly, who had reddish orange hair. So roll that footage. What's up, guys? Okay, so hopefully future Kelly has explained to you guys everything that's going on, but basically what we're gonna do today is we're gonna be creating our own color on the ORLY website and scheduling a virtual session to watch them mix it. So based on what I know already, I know I'm just gonna be picking the color today, and then in the virtual session I'm gonna be able to get to pick if I want any shimmer in it or make any slight changes to the polish. So I'm gonna be doing everything on my phone right now, and I am recording the screen, so I'll just pop it up right here so you guys can follow along with me as we explore the website and see what's going on. So I'm on the website, which is colorlabs.com, and I'm scrolling down to the virtual mixing session, and I'm gonna click make your color. So it says book a virtual appointment. Our mixologist will make your custom color with you via Zoom. Just follow the next steps. Step one, get started with your color design on your mobile phone. We're already here. Step two, complete your purchase and choose Zoom or mix and ship before checking out. If you choose to meet our mixologist for a Zoom session, don't miss the confirmation email with the scheduling link. If you choose mix and ship, we will just mix and ship your color. Well, we're definitely doing a Zoom session because it's free and I feel like I want to get the most out of this, so we're doing that. And then step three is meet our mixologist online. We'll work with you to make your ORLY custom color as special and unique as you. Optionally add pearl or metallic shimmer. So I'm just gonna click get started. So it says create a custom nail polish from any photo. I'm gonna click start here. So it says use your own photo or try one of ours. Just scrolling through, it looks like there's a lot of really great options. Honestly, I really don't know what color I'm thinking. Ooh, here's the purples. There's so many pretty purples in here. I feel like I should definitely do something purple, but I'm also curious to see how it works if I use my own photo. So I'm just gonna take a photo of my shirt really quick and see. This is a dirty shirt. Wow, I got some lint on this, guys. I don't want to hear your judgments. I'm gonna use it and just see what happens, okay? Just out of curiosity. It's just picking up on how dirty my shirt is. So yeah, it looks like you can actually just pick any of the colors that are present in the photo. And then there's a button that says adjust color. So if I wanted to match my shirt, I feel like I would just do a little bit of this, and I feel like that matches fine. I don't know, but I don't want to do an orange. I want to do a purple. So I'm going back. I think I'm just going to pick one of the stock photos because I feel like these photos are a lot prettier than anything I have on my phone. There's a little galaxy as the first photo. I feel like it's probably lame that I'm picking the first photo, but this is just a really pretty picture. You guys know I like galaxies, so let me see what colors they pull from that. Oh, and there is a really pretty soft purple. Ugh, imagine we should probably do, wait, I just thought of even something better. We should do a blue base, like the background of this, with a purple shimmer. That would be so pretty. This color, but maybe just a little bit more saturated. So let's try that. Something. This is gonna look dangerously close to their shade, It's Britney Beach. I'm gonna try to not do that. So I'm gonna make it kind of dark. Actually, I'm wondering if I should pick this one. Maybe I should pick this one that's a little bit more purpley. Wow, this is fun. I'm spending way too long on this. Okay, let me just pick a nice deep blurple color. I want like an indigo. Actually, now I feel like it's too purple. I know that obviously it's just what looks like on my screen. It's not gonna be exactly that color, but I don't know. I'm getting myself too worked up. Okay, I'm gonna go with this slightly dusty blue. And we're gonna go with a galaxy situation here. So I like this. I wanna add a purple shimmer in it. So we'll see if they can do that on the Zoom call. But for now, I'm going to name my color. Originally, I was thinking I should name it something like creative and cool and spacey. But the fact that it's just a custom shade, I feel like I really should just put my name on it. So I'm going to call it Kelly's Galaxy. And then it says, oh, there's a little free shipping code down here. So it says you can use the code FREESHIP for free shipping. And it's only $20, which is honestly crazy. I thought this was gonna be so much more expensive. So it says, let's get it right together. Schedule a session with an ORLY Color Labs mixologist to add shimmers and extra love. Recommended, and it's free. So I'm gonna click yes, please. So I have in my cart here, my Zoom mixing session and Kelly's Galaxy. So it's only $20. This is wild. So I'm gonna check out. I'm gonna kick you guys off really quick so I can put in my information, and then we'll come back and we'll schedule the Zoom call. Okay, so I'm back. I immediately got the email, so I just popped it up on my screen. So it says, we received your order. Get excited, because your ORLY Color Labs experience is about to get more fun. Now that you designed your color, please schedule a Zoom appointment. So I'm gonna click schedule Zoom session, so it pulls up the website. So it says it's gonna take about 30 minutes. It just says, we'll work with you to make your ORLY custom color as special and unique as you. And you can optionally add pearl or metallic shimmers. So I'm thinking we can just jump on to the next available, which is Tuesday the 12th, 3 p.m. sounds fine. So then it's just asking me for my name. Oh, I like that they can send a text reminder too. I'm not showing you guys this part just because I'm filling in my information, but I am scheduling. And here we go. So it says you are scheduled, and they also sent a calendar invite to my email address. All right, cool. So now I'm all scheduled and ready to go. So I will meet back up with you guys next Tuesday, and we will mix our color, and I will explain my galaxy idea to the mixologist, and we'll see what we create. So it'll be fun. Okay, so once I did that, I waited a few days until my Zoom meeting, and then we met up and we started to create my polish. So I did record that Zoom meeting. I've got all the footage. So let me show it to you.
So welcome, Kelly.
Hi.
I'll be your mixologist. So let's talk about what we're doing today. We're making Kelly's Galaxy, right?
Yes, I'm so excited.
Yeah. The way I usually start appointments is I just ask if there's anything that you want me to know about your color. And then what that process looks like is, like, once you tell me that, we'll get started mixing. I'll point you at my hand so you can watch me do what I'm doing.
I actually picked the color based off of one of the stock images on the website. It was like a really pretty purple galaxy in a dark blue background. So I was thinking that could be the inspo for the polish, but I'm also open to your ideas. So
yeah,
whatever works for you.
Well, whatever works for us. I think what we can do as that is like a jumping off point. There's a lot of stuff that we could do, but I think something that would be like really fun and dynamic is if we create kind of that like rich bluish base, that purplish bluish. We have shimmers that I think if we use a couple in combination with each other, it'll give it that sort of like 50 galactic vibe. I think
yes.
I would recommend most of all of our shimmers that we have to offer would be a combo of either a blue pearl in our blue metallic or our purple pearl in our blue metallic. I definitely think the blue metallic should be in there because it'll give it that kind of like night sky sort of sparkle.
Yes. Oh, I didn't know you could do more than one. Oh,
yeah.
That's even cooler. Okay.
To do all of them. I can't recommend that you do that, but you are allowed.
Just put every color in there.
Yeah. So I think the purple pearl might be a nice addition. Let me show you what those look like in actual action. See.
Okay.
This is what the blue pearl looks like. It's got that kind of...
Oh, yeah. I was actually... That's so funny. When I was thinking of the polish, I was thinking almost an inverse of that. Instead of a purple base with that bluey shimmer, like a bluey base with a purpley shimmer. So
yeah.
Very funny that you brought that up.
So our purple pearl in action looks something a little more like this. Our purple pearl,
right.
A little bit of a... More of a classic purple. This is a little bit of a cool purple. This one has a little bit more of like a kind of, I don't know if you can see that at all.
Yeah, no, I can see it. It's almost like a pinky purple.
Yeah, it's more pinky purple. And then it'll give us that nice contrast to our slightly bluer base, which will give it more of that kind of like dynamic, shifting, sort of opalescent quality. Mm-hmm. And then in there with the blue metallic, it'll have that kind of like starry night, kind of like individual.
My dream. Yes. Oh,
create some fun depth. And yeah, I think that is like a good direction for us to start.
I very much approve of this direction. Let's do it.
Okay, perfect. Okay, it'll definitely
be. Do you see that pinky purple in there? Oh,
let's give it a mix.
Oh man, how do you know how much to even put in at a time, like of the pigment?
It's a vibe. That's pretty much it, you know. It's
yeah, I like that answer.
I'm the senior mixologist here. I've been working here almost since we opened.
So you've got the experience. I'm sure there was a lot of trial and error too.
Experimenting, getting to know our individual polishes in there.
I'm going to be so boring because I already love this.
I can make some recommendations if you want to know how, just like my professional opinion, I think we could make it even better.
Oh, tell me. Oh my gosh, I can't even fathom this being better, but I'm also like very much not good at conceptualizing polishes.
Yeah. So I think to get it closer to kind of what we were talking about, what we could do is make the base bluer. You kind of like slate blue where it's got those kind of like gray and purple undertones. So if we make it a little bit bluer of a blue, I think it'll create more of a contrast between like the purple pearl, which is kind of our top note. And then you'll see more of that kind of like galactic sort of shifting of colors. I think that might make it even more.
I'm totally on board with that. I can see that shimmer in there. And I think that's such a gorgeous base. I would love to do anything we can to highlight that even more. Oh man, yeah, you were right. I can already see that it's better. I'm so bad at this.
You know, it's my whole job. It's to help guide you through the process.
Oh wow. Yeah, and I feel like it makes that purple even more obvious in there with that shimmer.
Because we've got less purple in that base. Do we like that? Do we want to take it a little further in that same direction? Is it
perfect? What are your thoughts? Because I feel like, I mean, again, I was happy with the first version. You somehow made it better. So you tell me what to do.
I think maybe if we were to tweak it at all, I think we could make that contrast pop just even a tiny bit more. So if we just do a little more of the same and maybe add another.
I'm fine with this.
There we go.
Oh my gosh. I love like when you first drop it in and you can see just how stark that contrast is. Oh, that's gorgeous.
So pretty.
Oh man, that really looks like so rich.
Super beautiful. We see all that blue, we see all that purple.
Yes. Oh my gosh, that is so gorgeous. Wow, I can't believe I was like happy with that first one. I can't believe that you made it so much better.
It's all about our collaborative process. So I think,
oh my gosh, that's so cool.
I think it's really beautiful. I think that
I think this is perfection.
The balance of those two elements we were trying to get in there. So unless you feel really strongly, I would say
I'm feeling really strongly that I like this.
Okay, then
I can't fathom it being better. Oh my gosh, I can't wait to get this on my nails. Ooh, and I feel like I know that it's pretty on camera, but once I see it in person, I feel like I'm just gonna freak out.
Yeah, you'll get even more of the whole experience.
Yes.
We're happy we'll bottle it.
Oh my gosh, I get to wash this too?
Yeah, it's the whole process.
This is like visual ASMR right here. Strong Kelly's Galaxy vibes here. This is perfection.
Get your label on there. So there she is. There's Kelly's Galaxy.
Look at that. Oh my gosh. I can see like the way that the light's hitting it. You get a little bit of that purple. Oh my gosh. Perfection. This is literally exactly what I had in my brain. And I have no idea how you managed to make it look exactly like my brain imagined it. I'm not very articulate about this stuff.
It's my job to interpret the desire.
That is an impressive skill. That was incredible. And just just watching that was such a cool experience. Oh my gosh, that was awesome. Amazing. Well, thank you so much for making Kelly's Galaxy. Wow.
You're so welcome. There she is again.
That's so cool. You know, I was thinking about just like naming it something random. I was like, this is a custom polish. I need to put my name on it.
Yeah, it's Kelly's polish. It's Kelly's Galaxy.
This is purely me. This is going to be my special Kelly brand nail polish.
Very much. Exactly that.
Perfection. She's gorgeous.
She's gorgeous. She's stunning. She's beautiful. Do you have any questions for me, Kelly, before I get this in the mail for you today?
Honestly, I don't. Is there anything that like frequently asked questions people should know about? I mean, I feel like that whole experience was just so straightforward, you know?
Yeah, it's like pretty straightforward. Usually, like, how long can I keep a nail polish in terms of how long you can keep a polish? Good rule of thumb is its peak freshness is 3 years, but you can, I mean, I'm sure you've experienced.
We'll see if it lasts that long before I use it up.
But, you know, I've had bottles of nail polish on my shelf for like 10 years before.
Oh, same. Oh my gosh. You don't get to collect as many nail polishes as I own without saving some decades old nail polishes.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh. This has been such a cool experience.
I'm so glad that you have fun, Kelly. Thank you so much for coming.
Thank you for having me. Oh my gosh. And I love that I don't even have to leave my own apartment. I'm wearing pajama pants right now. This is amazing.
I would be too. And in fact, I might be. You don't know.
Yeah, I have no idea. You could be.
So after our Zoom call, my nail polish was actually shipped that same day. So it arrived super quickly and it came in this beautiful little container, which by the way, when you open it, satisfying sound. But when you open it, there's all these little hands with nail polish on it, which is so cute. But anyway, so here is my nail polish, Kelly's Galaxy, which I also do have on my nails right now. And oh my gosh, let me just say, the Zoom call did not do this color justice. It is so much prettier in person. I can't wait to show you guys the whole swatch. So let me show you guys the swatches, because otherwise I'm just gonna gush about it for a really long time. So roll footage. So here she is in all of her glory, my beautiful Kelly's Galaxy. So as you can see, it's this really beautiful bright blue base with just the slightest bit of dustiness to it. And then inside we have this very vibrant violet shimmer running throughout, as well as those really beautiful blue metallic flecks, which are actually really subtle, but when they hit the light, they look so gorgeous. They actually do look like sparkling stars. Like seriously, this ended up looking so much more galaxy-like than I anticipated, and I am extraordinarily impressed. But anyway, I'm gonna do a quick review of this polish, even though obviously this one was custom made to me, so the formula isn't gonna be exactly the same for any polish you create, but obviously I have reviewed ORLY so many times before and their formula overall is just very impressive, and they are using the same supplies to create these, so you are gonna get that ORLY quality there. But yeah, this one ended up being fully opaque in two coats. As you can see in the light, it really does look like so many sparkling stars on my nails. I love that my vision was brought to life here with this blue base and this super vibrant purple shimmer. It's really everything I could have imagined, and it honestly looks exactly like the stock photo that I chose. So really beautiful overall, extremely satisfied with it. So yeah, that is Kelly's Galaxy, my custom nail polish color from ORLY. The experience itself was just so much fun. I wasn't expecting it to be so hands-on, especially considering it was virtual. It was really great to be able to work with an expert and create the best possible nail polish. Now obviously I couldn't be there, but I still felt like I was very present during the whole mixing experience. So it was just really fun. Honestly, would definitely do this again, especially considering that it's only $20. I feel like that's the biggest shock to me. I genuinely expected it to be like $40 to $60 for this experience, so was extremely impressed with the price point. And obviously for the amount of polish you get, I mean, it comes in their 18 milliliter bottles, so you basically just get a massive amount of nail polish for that. And it's a custom color, so just overall, absolutely awesome. I was thinking about it after the fact, and I feel like there's a lot of really cool ways that you can use the photo upload portion of their website. Like if you wanted to do something crazy, like match the color of your eyes or like something like that, I feel like that would be so cool. So there's really so many possibilities, and it's really fun to just be able to tweak it and let your ideas come to life. So that was definitely super fun. Oh man, I kind of want to like gift that experience to somebody, because I feel like that was really cool. But I would love to hear from you guys. What do you think of this experience? Would you be interested in trying this virtually? Have you tried it before? Let me know your thoughts on it, because I want to hear from from you. If you enjoyed this kind of swatch and review video, please give this one a thumbs up. If you want to see me do something like this again, just let me know. I feel like that could be a really fun video to do with a subscriber. Maybe it's like a giveaway or something. I don't know. We can think of something fun to do for this. And if you're not already subscribed to my channel, you should definitely consider subscribing because I put out new videos every Tuesday, Friday, and Sunday, and they're usually nail polish related, sometimes makeup related. But we have fun here, so you know, you may as well just join us. And that's it, so I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye! Today's fun fact question comes from Patreon supporter Miranda, and Miranda wants to know, if you got to name a newly discovered planet, what would you name it? Wow, that is so funny because I just reviewed a polish that I named Kelly's Galaxy. I should have thought about this ahead of time. But if I were to genuinely name a planet, I wouldn't just want to put my name on it. I feel like I would want it to be related to one of the features of the planet. Pick a word or a part of a word in a cool language, play off of that, you know what I mean? So it's really dependent on what kind of planet it would be and what are the features of the planet. Like, does it rain diamonds? I don't know. Is it blue? Are we just describing Neptune? I don't know. But yeah, I don't know. It would really have to depend on the planet, I feel, that I would have to, I would really have to determine. You know, you can't just name something without knowing that thing's personality, you know? Yeah, I don't know. Food for thought there. All right, I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.